And we're gonna see these players getting started here in our juniors finals.
Let's hear some noise for these players. We're getting underway. And Drake's kicking it off with a coin flip, capturing Aroma.
Capturing Aroma here. This is a card that we see popularized in Lugia, but it is now in Drake's Regidrago deck here. Of course, heads and tails gives you a different option here, but a heads means an evolution Pokemon is going to be searched out of the deck here for Drake, and that's pretty great because these evolution Pokemon are going to be wanting to go straight to that discard pile for Drake to be able to copy the moves later on in this match.
Yeah, a super good card in this deck specifically. Right away, Drake does grab from that first capturing Aroma, that Hisuian Gudra V-Star, so letting me know that is going to be a big part of his strategy. And he is playing a brand new card from Paldea Evolved. How about that Squawkabilly EX now hitting the bench?
Yep, we're squawking, we're seasoned here. That's gonna allow Drake to discard. I'm actually wondering what else is in the hand if we have some really nice discards here for Drake. And that Squawkabilly fits perfectly into this deck to be able to discard, draw into some more cards here. You can only do it on your first turn, so it's fantastic that Drake has gotten there to this point.
Discard and draw six new ones. I think the main thing Drake is looking for off of this, the one thing he's missing, is an Arceus V and a basic energy or a double turbo. And I see plenty of energy, but I actually do not see an Arceus V. That's gonna make it very difficult for Drake to have a good turn too.
Yeah, that is a big part of this deck. It's one of the energy accelerations. It's really like an engine in this deck, that Arceus V, Arceus V-Star, as well as that very powerful V-Star ability on the Arceus V-Star. And whiffing that is going to be difficult, especially because the Regidrago V-Star does take three energy to power up. Two grass, one fire energy. So it's going to be a little bit slower of a start here for Drake. We're over onto Prince's side here, and Battle VIP Pass is not a slow start, Chip, huh?
I was thinking the same thing. No slow starts on this end. Grabbing two Ralts right away. And it looks like Prince is going to take a moment to look through the prize cards. This is something we see all of our older division players doing. Just take a moment, make note of what you have access to and what you don't. Probably realizing, ooh, I do not have Mirage Step Curlia. One thing he will always be checking for as well is going to be that Mewtwo V Union. You only can utilize it if you have access to all four pieces. Now, we should mention Prince does also play one Peonia in this list, just kind of naturally pairs well with the Mewtwo V Union. If you prize a piece, you got to give yourself a chance to take one out. So there's a chance that Peonia could come through and find that Mirage Step, but I'm feeling like that's unlikely at this point.
Yeah, Prince taking the time to write down what is in the prize cards here. This is one way our players keep track of these resources, and it's very important. Something we see from our skilled players, it takes a little bit of mental energy off of your plates because then you don't have to sit there and try to remember, wait, was this in my prize cards? Oh, I could just write it down, and it's right there for me. And yeah, you do see Prince here eyeing up all those pieces of the Mewtwo V Union, one of the most interesting mechanics in the Pokemon trading card game. I feel like that is why a lot of our players continue to play Mewtwo V Union, just because it's so cool.
It is cool. I mean, it almost feels like something that was never meant to be competitive. It's kind of almost a novelty type of card. You get to put all four pieces together, but it just turns out that Mewtwo V Union has so many powerful attacks. You know, Psy Explosion, spreading 16 damage counters across your opponent's board. Super Regeneration, being able to take a hit with your massive 310 HP and then heal 200 damage with that attack. And when all else fails, you can close the game out with Final Burn for 300 damage.
Yeah, there's so many options there. Each piece of the Mewtwo having a different option for you to choose from. And that's a big part of why this card is so powerful, and it fits pretty perfectly into this deck. Definitely a different strategy than we're used to. We're gonna see that first reversal energy going down onto the field for that manual attachment for turn for Prince. And that looks like we're over here onto Drake's side.
Yeah, it looks like it. I think we're having a maybe chat with the judges about something. Looks like things are okay though. I believe Prince passed after attaching that energy card. Drake drew for turn pretty quickly.
Yeah.
And we are going to see the evolution into that Regidrago V-Star. And are we going to see? Oh, we are going to see the Regidrago use that Legacy Star ability, that V-Star power. Look at the top seven cards. Discard them, but then you get to pick two of them to put into your hand. Actually, you get to pick two from your discard pile, so you just discard the seven, and you can get anything back as well. Makes this card much more powerful.
Yeah, Drake, who was on Lugia V-Star before, used to discarding some cards here, but yeah, that is pretty wild of a V-Star power ability. Legacy Star, what a name as well.
Yeah, it's a great one. Now, I have to wonder here, is Drake even going to bother with going for Arceus at this point? You know, it's really strong to use that Trinity Nova, get some acceleration, and get your Regidragos powered up, but Prince is playing a bit slower version of a Gardevoir deck. It's pretty unlikely Prince is going to be able to do much to this Regidrago next turn, so it could be okay to just get a manual attachment for turn to this active and then find another grass energy next.
Yeah, that is very true. We already have that fire energy attached. We only need two grass left for this Regidrago V-Star. We see Prince reading this card here just to make sure to familiarize with everything that it's doing here. It's definitely not one that we see too often in the Pokemon TCG, but hey, we're in a brand new format and our players are out here innovating with these brand new decks. So we're still looking through these cards here for Drake.
Yeah, it looks like he's chosen one. Still debating what this second one might be. Palpad could be an option. I think he did discard quite a few powerful supporters. Also, Super Rod is being debated. There is another Regidrago V-Star in the discard pile already. So that could be something he feels like he needs to try to get back. He does only play a 2-2 line of that attacker.
Yeah, look, they're even reading, I think, the V-Star of this right now as well, just to make sure we're doing everything correctly. But those are going to be the two cards drawn out of the discard pile now. We're going to have that manual attachment of the grass energy onto the Regidrago V-Star. Just one more needed here. Path to the Peak is also going to come down into play, shutting down abilities of V Pokemon here.
And Super Rod will place back three Pokemon to the deck, including that Regidrago V-Star and also a Curlia and a Gallade. Something a little unique about Drake's list is that he's playing a Curlia line in here to use that refinement ability, discard those dragon Pokemon so you can copy their different attacks with Apex Dragon. And he's also got that Buddy Catch Gallade to just lend a little helping hand when you need it.
Yeah, allowing you to search out a supporter during your turn. That is very much a helping hand. Supporters are so powerful here in the Pokemon trading card game. And a little buddy catch action might be what we're seeing later on in this match here from Prince. But still going through this turn here for Drake's side.
He did play the research, but I don't see another grass energy for the next turn, which is kind of awkward. And Arceus V-Star does lose quite a bit of value when you don't have that Trinity or that V-Star power V-Star option available to be able to use Starbirth.
Yeah, look at that. Ultra Ball discarding an Arceus V and an Arceus V-Star. So that is not what is going to be going for here with that Ultra Ball. Searching out a Ralts from the deck.
Try to prep for a potential Curlia next turn. Maybe crossing your fingers that you top deck one of those pieces. And I think that is what it's going to have to be, because Drake's hand is really not very good.
Just some energy in there.
The nice thing for this, though, for Drake, is that Prince's deck is not really built to be able to punish a slower start. It's a little harder to get built up with enough energy in play, especially with just the three Ralts. Normally, you're going for the turn two Mirage Step. As we know, though, not an option this game.
Look at that chip. It was a top deck of the Curlia. That was huge here. That's going to lead to the refinement, discarding that psychic energy and drawing into two additional cards to Prince's hand.
Yeah, two additional cards, but not much else to help. Both of these players having really clunky starts here in the finals. Just a pass.
Yeah, the manual attachment there. And the
top deck of the grass energy.
Energy here for Drake. That was so needed, and it was found. That is going to turn that Regidrago V-Star online here to start copying the attacks of these dragon Pokemon in the discard pile.
That is the difference between Drake doing something this turn and doing
nothing
this turn. What a massive draw. And this is going to put Drake in a great spot. Use that Rolling Iron, take a KO, take your first prize. It looks like he also has the Noivern EX in his discard pile, so that is something else that could be an option. A brand new card from Paldea Evolved, Covert Flight could be the option. prevent all damage done to this Pokemon by basics, or the Dominating Echo 140, and during your opponent's next turn, they can't play any special energy or stadium. Pretty good when your opponent plays four reversal energy.
Yeah, that is brutal indeed. So we have the knockout here. Drake is going to be the first to a prize card thanks to that incredible top deck. We're over here on Prince's side. Now we're going to have another Curlia come down thanks to that level ball, being able to search out a Pokemon from the deck with 90 HP or less. So usually the targets are your Ralts and your Curlia. Mm-hmm. And the Curlia being so important here for that refinement ability to get some more cards into Prince's hands, because I think it's pretty needed here. We can also mention refinement works very well with these Mewtwo V Union pieces, being able to get them into the discard as well as draw more cards into your hand.
Yeah, we have to mention as well Drake having that path to the peak in play, and I'm assuming using that Dominating Echo attack on the Noivern means that Prince is going to be a little disadvantaged here. He's going to have a hard time finding a way to power up his Pokemon. Usually you rely on Gardevoir EX and Reversal Energy, and Dominating Echo, just a one attack option, really kind of counters your entire strategy.
Yeah, you're blocking too much here if you're not able to attach any energy or play a stadium card either.
And I think that's why.
What are you supposed to do? Yeah, you're just getting walled.
You are getting walled, but I think that that's why we're seeing this specific Ralts be included. And I think Prince is probably very thankful that he chose to include this one of Ralts in his list, the Memory Skip attack. Normally, these evolving basics have pretty unassuming attacks and unimpactful, but Ralts is anything but unimpactful. 10 damage, and then choose one of your opponent's active Pokemon's attacks, and they cannot use it during the next turn. That's going to be Prince's out here. Use Memory Skip. When combined with this Iono, choose the Apex Dragon and hope Drake does not have a switch.
So it's blocking versus blocking here from both of these players, counteracting the effects of their Pokemon in this deck. And yeah, that is going to be the answer here.
Hits the energy.
We see the energy onto that Ralts now, that Memory Skip Ralts, so important in this matchup now.
Refinement can ditch a VIP pass. And it is going to be that retreat now. Memory Skip incoming. Here's the question. Does Drake have a switching card and an energy or something to retreat whatever Pokemon he switches into back into the active spot? If Drake can KO the Ralts this turn, he's in a just fine spot.
Yeah, but Drake was also working.
I don't know what attack Drake announced, I guess. That is something we should check. If he did announce the Dominating Echo, Prince should not be able to attach that reversal energy.
Yeah, that's true. That is one thing I guess we wouldn't be able to tell from here on.
Yeah, we don't know for sure which attack he announced. It could have been Rolling Iron, but we will need to check on that.
Yep, it looks like we're having Drake writing down some things here on the side notes.
But regardless, the Memory Skip got this energy thanks to the Shining Arcana. 10 damage, that one little damage counter doing the most.
Yeah, one damage counter, but such
a
powerful effect. We have the switch here for Drake.
And I think maybe we're getting caught up on the attachment of this energy card.
Yeah, potentially, but we're just going to see a Nest Ball, so it looks like these players are moving forward from here. Nest Ball to search out a basic Pokemon from the deck here for Drake.
Yeah, and it looks like that energy's been returned to the hand, so we can assume that Dominating Echo was the attack that was announced.
Well, that's a quick fix here, just taking an energy off the board. It was being blocked there from that Noivern. But yeah, we saw the switch here from Drake, and this is going to be the Iono. Both our players shuffling their hands. It's going to go to the bottom of their decks here, and they're going to draw a card for every single prize card that they still have left. So Prince is going to draw 6. Drake will be drawing 5.
And Drake needs just an energy card here to retreat this Ralts. Maybe another switching card could work as well. Really crossing his fingers to find one. And I don't see an energy. There's a Curlia, though.
Yeah, there's refinement here.
This does cut down on your outs a little bit, though, because now you have to find specifically double turbo energy.
Yep, that's true. 2 retreat costs now for that Curlia. So that is what it's going to require instead of just that one off of the Ralts. Ultra Ball going to discard 2 cards. We see that Spiritomb and a Garchomp V as well being discarded to that Ultra Ball.
Drawing 2. Does Drake find a double turbo?
It looked like it, Chip, but I don't think it is. I think we would see that attachment, and we did not. It's just going to have to be a pass here to Prince. And let's see what Prince has, because we are working with an Iono hand here now. So six cards off the Iono, draw for turn, making seven. We have some options.
Yeah, this is a huge opening for Prince. He's been able to accomplish exactly what he was hoping to do. Memory skip, buy a turn, make it so Regidrago cannot attack. Prince needs to do something with this. He has to find an Artisan, replace this stadium, and has to get a Gardevoir EX in play and try to find a way to accelerate energy cards. Can also, of course, now attach this reversal energy because that Dominating Echo was not the attack announced last turn. There was no attack announced last turn.
Yep.
Prince really needs to capitalize on this position that he's been able to maneuver.
Yeah, when you get an option like this, you got to use all the resources that you can before it's blocked out again. And honestly, it's looking pretty good here for Prince. There's a lot of options in the hand, including that reversal energy that is instantly going to come down here onto that Curlia. Of course, had to get picked up last time because of that Noivern, but it's in play now for Prince and just deciding to do or what to do with the rest of this hand here. Going to start with that Shining Arcana ability on the Gardevoir here. Going to draw those two cards. If one was a basic Psychic, could have been attached, but it's going to find the Ultra Ball.
Yeah, and two Mewtwo V Union pieces going to the discard pile.
We're
exactly
almost there,
what
Chip.
You want to do. What are we at, like 50%, 75% of the way
there? 75, yeah, because one
just around the corner.
Went with a refinement earlier, so Prince is getting there. And what a perfect discard, too. Ultra Ball for two pieces of a Pokemon that you want in the discard pile. So, looks great.
And can grab the other piece out here. I think there is a Professor's Research in this hand, or at least another Ultra Ball. I think Prince just taking a moment trying to navigate out exactly what else in hand can be discarded.
Yeah, there's a lot here that Prince has to do. Not wanting to make any mistakes here. Ultra Ball is going to search out that last piece. It's the head, Chip, of that Mewtwo.
And with one more energy in hand, or one more Ultra Ball, I should say, Prince can now discard this piece as well. He's got a switching card. There's a level ball, too. This can get maybe one more Ralts established.
Yep, just going to go through the deck here, grabbing a Pokemon out, and it is going to be that Ralts being, or sorry, that Curlia being eyed up here. That works as well.
Yep, Curlia can be a good option. Of course, like we mentioned on last turn for Drake, it does have a two retreat cost, so if Prince wants to evolve this active Ralts into a Curlia to draw some more cards, needs to make sure to retreat first.
All right, we're shuffling up here, but things are starting to come together now for Prince. Like you said, Chip, this was a huge opening, and Prince is taking full advantage of it so far in this turn. We're almost there to that Mewtwo V Union. We have another Ultra Ball here, and that's going to be one of the pieces discarded to it, along with the Psychic Energy as well. Prince going to go into the deck one more time. Any Pokemon can come out of that deck now off that Ultra Ball, but even more important, we're at 100%, Chip, of that Mewtwo.
Oh, and this is going to be an interesting strategy here. Does grab the Gallade with that Buddy Catch. Can now find a Boss's Orders, get some damage in play onto a Regidrago, and at the same time, preserve the energy. This Swirling Slice attack deals 160 and moves an energy attached from this Pokemon to the bench. So you can set up for a two-hit knockout on the Regidrago V-Star while trying to protect this energy that you otherwise might not be able to attach next turn thanks to the Noivern's attack.
Yep, that's why that Gallade goes perfectly into this deck.
Ooh, chasing after the prizes here.
Ooh, it's going to be a switch into that Gallade, but the Squawk ability EX is what's going to be coming up into the active position off of that Boss's Orders here from Prince. Gusting it up, it's going to be two prize cards.
Yeah, I could understand wanting to maybe set up a two-hit knockout on this Regidrago. It's really the only threat on Drake's side of the field, but the ability to take a two-prize KO on a one with a one-prize Pokemon is something that is maybe just a little too tempting to pass up.
Yeah, would then be leading in the prize cards, though, which is a big factor for that reversal energy. You have to be behind in prize cards in order to play it down and have that effect there. We're going to have the Ralts come out onto the bench from that level ball.
Yep, grabbing that back after the Super Rod put it back into the deck. Of course, it was KO'd by Drake on the two turns ago at this point. But yeah, if Prince had set up for a two-hit knockout on the Regidrago, like we mentioned, it's really all Drake has set up at this point. So you go for the two-hit KO there. You assume Drake takes a knockout on the active Gallade and then takes a knockout on the Gardevoir on the next turn. Drake's down to three prizes left, and Prince would have only taken two, which would mean Reversal Energy would still be active.
Yeah, and you got to think, too, Drake's hands have not been the best here. Seems to be struggling quite a bit. We do see a Judge, and that looks like it's going to have to be the option here for Drake. Judge coming into play. Both these players shuffling up the hands, going to draw into four brand new cards. So that is actually going to dwindle down Prince's previous pretty large hand down to just four.
Now, it is worth noting the Gallade does have 160 HP. So it is something that cannot be knocked out by the Noivern. So that makes things a little awkward if Drake wants to play around the potential of Reversal Energy. But honestly, Drake could still just go for the Dominating Echo this turn. Keep just that wall. Path to the Peak locked in play. Deal 140 damage. It feels a little bad to have to two-hit KO a one-prize Pokemon, but I don't think Prince could even do anything about that. The Gallade has two retreat. It would be pretty much stuck in the active spot unless Prince could find a switch.
Well, we'll have to see what Drake decides to go with, eyeing up the Hisuian Gudra. I think that was actually the option there. It looked like that was the last look there on that Gudra. So
going
to take the knockout. Yep, does enough damage, of course, to take this knockout on the Gallade versus that Noivern. So not going to go for the lock. Going to take the prize card here.
And I think
Prince having to decide what to promote into the active.
Yeah, this seems okay as well. You know that you're tied on prizes, so Reversal Energy is not activated. It does, however, open up a chance for Prince to replace your stadium card, get this Path to the Peak out of play with the Artisan that he plays, and then get into a Gardevoir EX. It's got a lot of HP, and it can still do a lot of damage. So if Prince can get off an attack with a Gardy EX here, I think that would be really good. He also could potentially set up the Mewtwo V Union this turn. It would require a lot from him. We'll see if he has the hand to make it happen.
Yep, it's just going to be the promotion of that Ralts into the active position, and Prince is going to have to decide where to go from here with this hand. We have the Palpad, the Manaphy, another Reversal Energy. Still have some options with the Refinement. Curlia here, Shining Arcana, can still be used. This is the beginning of the turn here, so it looks like we're starting off with that Shining Arcana ability off of this Gardevoir on the bench.
Yep, this will draw two pieces.
Oh, I think there's a card dropped, but it was just picked up here by Prince.
Yep, two cards added to the hand. If it's an energy, a basic energy, you can attach it. It was a Reversal Energy, but not a basic. There's a rare candy in this hand, though.
Yeah, it just got drawn, I think, off of that Shining Arcana. So rare candy now in the hands. Looks like that's going to be the discard for the Refinement here now. Manaphy hitting that discard pile. Here's that basic energy.
Does
and an
find
Artisan.
The Artisan. But I don't think there's really a lot going for Prince in this current hand. I think what his play might have to be is rare candy or maybe just manually evolve this benched Curlia into the other Shining Arcana Gardevoir. You've got rare candy in hand, and then just hope that you can draw into your Gardevoir EX with this last Shining Arcana.
Yeah, the draws have been a little bit clunky here. It just feels like we're missing just a couple of pieces for Prince to be able to get something together here. We did see that Super Rod, which is going to be three Pokemon coming out of the discard pile, being shuffled back into the deck. So that Gallade is back in the deck now. And we see the Artisan bumping that Path to the Peak that was blocking the abilities of Rulebox Pokemon. And Artisan is also going to allow for Prince to shuffle through the deck once again, get out a basic Pokemon here if he wants, or just take a look at the deck and fail the search.
Yeah, did grab that Ralts that he put back. They keep going down, but they keep coming back because that is an important piece of any Gardevoir deck. Does have the ability to attach another Reversal Energy this turn. And maybe this is Prince's hope. Just get a large Shining Arcana Gardevoir built up so that you can do something on the next turn.
Yeah, taking it slow here. Just going to attach and pass back over now to Drake. Drake, last turn, did get that acceleration of that energy, that grass energy, loaded up another Regidrago on the bench already. Of course, we still have this one in the active, but there's a whole nother one being prepped and ready to go on the bench as well. So further developing this field here for Drake. Taking a look at the deck here. There's not a lot of cards left here, Chip.
Yeah, using the Artisan on Prince's side so that Drake is also, you know, able to make use of this stadium card and try to find maybe a Ralts is what he was hoping for, but yeah. Does not look like that is an option. Must be in the discard pile or could still be hiding in the prizes.
I think it's still in the prizes because I think it was like the middle prize that we saw there. So probably hasn't been taken. Only two prize cards have been taken here for Drake. Usually our players go for the bottom prize cards.
I think Drake here is digging for boss's orders and he does not quite find it. If he could have used boss and taken out the Gardevoir on Prince's bench, that would have been really good. But he can get the Gallade and Gallade can find the boss's orders. All right, that makes it work.
We see Gallade versus Gallade, both of these players utilizing that buddy catch in their deck to search out a supporter Pokemon. That will get the boss's orders here for Drake. Incredible play there.
Well done. I was a little surprised to see the Gallade come out.
I mean,
it's a little surprising to see it even in a Gardevoir deck, let alone in a Regidrago deck. But this boss's orders brings up the Gardevoir and Boo, Gardevoir does only have 140 HP, meaning that it is KO'd by Dominating Echo.
It's KO'd, and then the lock is going to be reestablished there. So no stadiums and no special energy. Such an incredible card in this deck, and probably one of the reasons Drake decided to play this deck, because it does counter decks like this.
Unfortunately, though, for Drake, he was unable to get rid of the Artisan and get his own path to the peak in play. Really would have liked to have locked a different stadium in play. Also, for Prince, you can't go for the same play that you did last time. If we look right here, that is the Memory Skip Ralts underneath that Kirlia. So cannot go for the Memory Skip like he did previously to try to get out of this type of situation. Taking a moment to look through the discard pile. Prince now having a hard time figuring out what to even promote here, where to even go. You're staring down a Regidrago with just two Ralts into Kirlia.
Yeah, and you got to think too, you know, we've been casting this match so far turn for turn. Drake is only down to three prize cards left to take. To take the win in this first game between our players. So things are starting to get narrowed down here. Prince has to put something together, being on a little bit of a back foot. We do see the Gallade getting drawn into that was recycled back into the deck from that Super Raw the turn before.
So that is an option. Can evolve this Kirlia up into the Gallade. I think Prince would love to get Gardevoir EX here. And That is the basis of Prince's deck, is Gardevoir EX.
We haven't seen it.
We haven't seen it once. This is his real one opening to get the Gardevoir and to get the Mewtwo V-Union. He does have Ultra Ball in hand. Is this what he's going to go for? Can Ultra Ball, and then also has Rare Candy? I mean, if there's any time to do it, now seems like a great one.
Yeah, it looks like just eyeing up the options.
Rare Candy into Gallade could fetch out a specific supporter.
It's just a tough choice to be making here, but it's going to be that Rare Candy back into the Buddy Catch Gallade here now.
And with the Pal Pad being played, you can guarantee quite a few different supporters pulled out of the deck as options for the Buddy Catch. Looks like Iono is going to be one of them, a card we've seen consistently throughout the weekend. Drake is ahead on prize cards right now.
Yep, you could have that hand narrowed down to just three cards for Drake, and then all the cards in Drake's hand would also go to the bottom of the deck, so that is an option here. Boss's Orders being the other card recycled back into the deck as well.
So Prince has all the Mewtwo pieces in the discard pile, right?
100%.
He's probably a little nervous about the potential of a Giratina using Lost Impact to one-hit KO that Mewtwo for three prizes, but Mewtwo is the best way to try to respond to this Regidrago. It would require you to damage it pretty heavily, so he can't go for that option just yet. And it looks like Prince actually wanting to be aggressive after the Buddy Catch Gallade, try to limit all of Drake's options moving forward. The problem with a play like this, though, is that you put yourself on the odd prizes.
Yes.
And you're still going to have to KO two V-Star Pokemon if you want to win this game.
Yeah, you're working on an uphill battle. That Reversal Energy is such an interesting card, but that is one major proponent of it. You have to be behind.
Here it is. Mewtwo. Oh, we're thinking about it.
Oh, yeah. It came down, but it came back up.
Really thinking about assembling that Mewtwo V Union. There it is into play.
Yeah, all we need some pieces. Cheers here for that Mewtwo V Union. You rarely get to see this in the Pokemon TCG, and it is always fantastic when it comes out. This is what we wish for here, Chip.
Yep. One more opportunity. I mean, and it seems fitting as well. We're back at NAIC, where Sander Wojcik last year put Mewtwo V Union on the map. Now it is Prince putting it on the board.
Debuted it, and it is back. Absolutely epic to see four cards being assembled onto the board, say here. But Prince is going to have to decide. It just looks like making such difficult decisions here with this hand, but is looking to maybe evolve into that Shining Arcana Gardevoir, but is going to go for the Ultra Ball instead, discarding two cards.
Go for the Ultra Ball instead. Does find that Gardevoir EX. Psychic Embrace can accelerate energy to this Pokemon. It is going to take a lot of damage, and I think what Prince's play might be here is to go for the Size Explosion. Bring up this Gallade. It's got two retreat. It's a bit chunky, a little hard to move, so bring it up and then use Size Explosion, spread damage onto the threats on the bench. Maybe that's what he's going for.
Yeah, potentially taking multi-prize card knockouts in this game. That is a potential for Prince to do. We'll see what happens here with this Mewtwo V Union. There's tons of options, of course. Every single one of those individual cards has a different move on it and an ability as well.
Yes, and we do need to remember as well, though, Drake is just at three prize cards remaining. So this is becoming a perilous situation. If Prince's Mewtwo V Union goes down, Drake could just win the game. Three prizes given up for that four-piece Pokemon.
Yeah, I mean, I guess that's pretty warranted, huh, Chip? It's hard.
Yeah.
It's very hard to take down. 310 HP, so powerful. I'd hope you get some three prize cards off of that that baby right there.
Drake does have a double turbo energy in hand, so that means Gallade can retreat.
That's true. Double turbo counting as two energy here, allowing for that. Drake just eyeing it up, just trying to decide what to do here. It looks like going into the deck with that Artisan, taking a quick look at what is left here, just going to fail it, shuffle things up. The cards have been being drawn out of this deck here for Drake, and it's looking slim, but there's still plenty of time left here to conclude this match. We're going to have to see which way it goes. We're going to see the manual attachment to be able to retreat.
Oh.
That's Gallade here.
Almost retreated into the wrong Regidrago, the one with only two energy on it. Took a second, realized we needed to retreat into the one with the correct amount of energy to attack. Now Buddy Catch going back into the deck can grab any supporter card.
Yeah, they look so similar here, Chip, but one of them is online, ready to attack with that Apex Dragon. The other one, just one energy, one grass energy away from being lined up, ready to do that as well.
So Drake will be able to pull off the attack, assuming he will go for the Dominating Echo once again. I don't think he has any options as far as great supporters to play. There's a Research in hand, but he definitely has less than seven cards left in this deck.
Yeah, and that is another win condition. I was talking about taking all six prize cards, but if you deck out, you also lose the game as well. So that is going to be something we're keeping an eye out for.
This is Prince's chance. He needs to pull something off here, get some energy in play. The top deck of the psychic energy is decent. And maybe Prince's one hope here is that he loads all of the energy up onto the Mewtwo V Union, and Drake just doesn't have a grass energy. If Drake doesn't have a grass energy, Prince can take two prizes, two turns in a row with the final burn of Mewtwo V Union. It doesn't look like Prince thinks that's very likely. He's gonna concede game one, and Drake is going to get the win in our first game of the Junior Division Finals.
Chip, I am definitely not disappointed here. These players are pulling out all of the stops. Two very unique decks. You know, when I was talking to people, talking about casting the Juniors and Seniors Finals, what decks we're gonna be casting, we saw some shocked faces because this is not what we are used to seeing here, but it's a brand new format. We're seeing some new decks coming out of the woodwork, and two of them being piloted by some of the most skilled Juniors Division players. And we saw that here in this match.
And for Drake, this is massive. He was a finalist at EUIC, meaning he lost in that last match. Remy was able to take it down, become the international champion. this is a shot at redemption. He is just one game away from becoming an international champion. On Prince's side of the field, gotta take a second, compose yourself. You're one game down, but you are far from out of this match. Just two games separate you from becoming the international champion. I can't wait to see what's gonna happen, Boo, in our game number two.
Yep, eyeing up those trophies there. That is what our players are playing for as well. And we'll see who gets there. I'm excited to see if Drake can take another game down, take a 2-0 and win NAIC, become an international champion, or if Prince is gonna be able to fight back, maybe change up the strategy a little bit here in this next game, have some more availability to those reversal energies, and be able to take advantage of this board. I mean, such a major play that, well, I should say major top deck that we saw from Drake was that grass energy.
Yes.
Imagine which way that game would have gone if we didn't get to see that grass energy come out. It would have been absolutely detrimental. So that could happen again. Drake plays so many different cards here. It can get clunky, it can get awkward. And if we see some bad draws, things could really go Prince's way this time around. So what do you think between both of these players, Chip? Are we gonna see some switch up of strategy? I feel like Drake had it pretty solid there.
Yeah, I'd love to see Drake kind of approach the same mindset. Going for that Noivern, having the option of the Rolling Iron, just got set up pretty nicely. I think he'd like to get that Arceus V-Star up and running if he could. That would be pretty strong. But if you have to go about it a little bit slower like you did in game number one, we know that it's not the end of the world because he was able to get the win still. Prize cards going out. A couple of grass energy in the prizes for Drake. How many does he have in the list?
There's five total in the list, so still a couple left in deck. But again, Reggie Drago takes two.
Yeah.
It's one fire, two grass energy. So it is a bit awkward. Of course, Drake can draw in to those grass energy, taking some prize cards. One is ripe for the pick in there at the bottom. We're gonna also see a Curlia in the prize cards. It is a 2-2 line, Ralts Curlia in Drake's deck as well. So still have options there. We'll have to see what Prince puts out into the prize cards after resolving this mulligan. You have to start the Pokemon TCG with a basic Pokemon in your active. And if you're not able to find that off your initial hand, you reshuffle until you find one in that initial hand. But you're also giving cards to your opponents, because for each mulligan, they get plus one card to their hand before the game begins.
Worth noting as well, we've gotten through about half the time allotted, 75 minutes here for our finals match. It's a best of three, and that first game took quite a bit of time off the clock. So that's something players will have to be a bit mindful of moving into these next games.
Chip, time flies when you're having fun and assembling Mewtwo V unions, you know?
I know, right. I'm having fun. I know these players are having fun. I hope our audience here is having fun as well. Just a couple games left. And that memory skip Ralts in the prizes, that is something that could be big for Prince.
Yeah, luckily it is on the bottom of the prize cards, but yeah, we saw it be so impactful to the initial setup in our game one. Let's kick off this game two in our juniors finals. Only one game away from Drake potentially being a champion, but Prince has every opportunity to take a game down and into a game three. Let's see where this goes, Chip. Ultra Ball is gonna start things off on Prince's side of the field here, discarding a couple of Pokemon to that Ultra Ball.
Right away, checking the prizes and sees that Memory Skip Curlia is available, has access, or not Memory Skip, the Mirage Step. Memory Skip Ralts, of course, in the prizes. Mirage Step Curlia is available in the deck, something he was unable to go for in the last game. But Ultra Ball did discard a couple Pokemon, so right away, Prince feeling pressured maybe to try and find a Super Rod. I will also mention it, for Prince, he does not play the Mew that we're so used to seeing in these Gardevoir lists. You really don't have space for that when you're trying to fit in the Mewtwo V Union, fit in the reversal energies, fit in some tech cards like that Luxray we saw in the prizes as well. When you're trying to get all these cards in, you have to cut down on consistency somewhere. So not having Mew to retreat into on turn one, go for Mysterious Tail, that could be a detriment in a position like this.
I mean, Gardevoir, like traditional Gardevoir decks barely have room for the Mew.
Yeah.
It's like a one copy in there, so.
But that one is so important.
It is very important. That's why it is slotted into that deck, but that is not gonna be an option here. I mean, you gotta think, this build of Gardevoir is very different from the more popular version of Gardevoir that we saw a lot during our Masters matches. But this is very, very different approach to this. What do you think, Chip? Why do you think a player would choose to bring this version over the more traditional, popular Gardevoir deck?
It's about what we talked about in the top of the show here. It's just having something a little unexpected. When you're playing Reversal Energy, your opponent might not really keeping track of how much damage you truly can do. They might not be expecting multiple copies of the card. And then, of course, Mewtwo V Union just being such a strong finisher at the end of the game. And it gives you a much better chance against Lost Box, as well as Sizeplosion is just guaranteed to take two prizes against that single prize matchup.
Yeah, we even saw in the prize cards as well for Prince that Luxray, who we haven't seen a ton of throughout this weekend, but that is another card that is able to get slotted into these decks because of that Reversal Energy. Just doing 180 damage onto the field can be a very nice closeout card potentially in some matches.
So this Ultra Ball for Prince will just grab the Kirlia, not choosing to establish another Ralts, and there is an option here for Drake to try to disrupt this. Drake has the knowledge now that Prince has this Kirlia in hand, so if Drake can find a Judge or an Iono, that would take that option away.
Yeah, that would be rough for sure.
I think looks like an Ultra Ball being considered here for Drake. Probably wants to establish Arceus V-Star. I have to imagine, even though we didn't see it in game number one, that it is a pretty big part of your deck's overall strategy in most games, and I do believe he already has a double Turbo Energy in hand. So it does look like he can get that attachment, and it has that Iono as well, Boo. Exactly what we were talking about.
That disruption, we've been talking about it all throughout the weekend here, Iono. So we're gonna have both of these players drawing into fresh hands of six here off of that, all the rest of their cards going to the bottom of their deck, but that does mean that Kirlia is now gone. We'll see what the hand brings, though. Could still be a solid hand, potentially, or could be very awkward, but we do see a couple cards that can come in handy there for Prince. Doesn't look too terrible. It's just gonna be a pass over now. Let's see what Prince can establish here. Of course, went first. This is the second turn. Radiant Greninja is gonna be able to help out here with that concealed cards ability, discarding that psychic energy and getting two cards to the hand.
Prince was able to find Ultra Ball and Level Ball, meaning he can just go get that Kirlia right back.
There's two Ultra Ball.
Yep, and we do know as well, though, that the one Kirlia, that Refinement Kirlia, did get discarded. So that is something that is not going to be able to be brought out of the deck with the Mirage Step here, making this turn feel a little bit slower than it otherwise could have.
The Mirage Step is so cool, though. I don't think we've seen that in any of our Gardevoir list so far, but this one plays it. You're allowed to search your deck for up to three Kirlia, and that's going to help a lot with this draw engine. And, of course, evolving into the Gardevoir, into the Gallade here for Prince as well.
And Prince going for an Iono of his own, disrupting Drake's side of the field, drawing himself some extra cards. A little risky. There's a chance you draw some of your Kirlia into your hand, and if you draw Kirlia, you're not able to accelerate them into play with Mirage Step. It's the good old water duplicates conundrum.
Well, we don't see it yet, at least. Yeah, it looks like going to be safe here for this turn. And, of course, finds that Super Rod. That is huge because these two Pokemon that were discarded in the very first turn are being recycled into the deck, available to now be drawn out off of that Mirage Step. That was big.
That was such a massive hit. Mirage Step will now be able to put three Kirlia directly into play, and even this Level Ball can now go get a Ralts so that that can be a rare candy target. We could see five evolutions of Gardevoir, or of Ralts, I should say, between Gardevoir, the Gallade, in play all at the same time.
That would be wild to see, Chip. But I guess it is a possibility with this version of the deck. And I gotta say, huge props to Prince bringing this deck out here and putting it on the map.
and does find the one copy of Path to the Peak that he plays, and this is a great turn to do it. Shut down the potential of that Starbirth V-Star power from Drake. The perfect time to find this key one of Stadium.
Yeah, this has been an incredible turn so far here for Prince. All these Pokemon coming out here. Path to the Peak for that disruption. That's going to hinder Drake so much because we saw so much in our game one that Drake had some really awkward hands, some awkward draws, even was living off a top deck. So that could just be the edge to put Prince out on top here. It was such a weird beginning turn, but things have really begun to establish here for Prince's end of the field.
Yeah, let's remember as well, there is a Kirlia in the prizes, so that Super Rod was even more impactful than we initially thought, because this Mirage Step was only going to get one Kirlia into play if that recovery option was not found.
We're going to just see the pass over to Drake. Now, starting off this turn, does find the Regidrago V-Star here, looking through the discard pile. There hasn't been, I think, a single Pokemon discarded into there yet.
Has Escape Rope, so worst case scenario, could pull off the Trinity Charge, just get a bunch of energy onto the various Regidrago on the bench. Also has Switch, if he would rather do that. That works too, having either option available. And Boss's Orders as a stall option, maybe bring up this Greninja, try to buy a turn. The hand does look pretty weak, I have to say.
Yeah, and that's where you can get sometimes, unfortunately. This deck, there's so many cards in it, and we might see the awkward hands begin to strike again here for Drake. Gonna get a look through Prince's discard pile so far, just monitoring what resources have been played thus in this game.
Yeah, this deck is definitely a little clunky compared to some of the other Arceus V-Star decks we've seen over the weekend, but you can tell how powerful it is. It's got so many options and so many matchups that you can cover. We do see the switch now, Trinity Charge online, not choosing to play the boss, just gonna hold off on that piece for later. I do like that.
Yeah, the Trinity Charge is gonna help out so much here to search out these energy and accelerate them onto your field. This was what was missed in game one, but Drake was still able to pull things out. We'll see how the Arceus V and potentially a V star being in play affects this match going forward. Of course, up to three energy allowed to be searched out with this Trinity Charge. Doesn't do any damage, but allows Drake to fully establish a field here. Of course, can attach to this Arceus V as well to get that online, and then two grass that are needed to go onto this Regidrago on the bench. Ready to go.
Yeah, I love the fact that Drake chose to put an energy onto his active Arceus. That way he can be prepared to attack with it on the next turn, even if it's just a Power Edge. You've got Boss's Orders in hand, so that can guaranteed take a knockout on something like a Kirlia. Get a little bit of momentum going, start to take some prize cards.
Yeah, both of these players actually getting a pretty solid start here. A little bit awkward at first, but we're seeing things kind of iron out for both of these players in their developed board states. I like to see it, Chip. Starting over on Prince's side of the field now with one of those refinement, discarding an Artisan that is one stadium down, but Path to the Peak is in play, and that's what you want in play here. Battle VIP pass being the next discard for another refinement. Anything in this hand, Chip, that's going to help us out this turn? Well, that's one thing.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be a Peonia. Looking at three prize cards, adding them to the hand, and then placing three prize cards back out. So this works in a couple ways. He can drop a couple cards in there that he knows he doesn't need in this matchup, knows he won't need for a while at least, and then maybe take them later on, and then also hopefully find some key resources. Would you know one Ralts was in the prizes and it was at the bottom, so decent shot that Ralts was grabbed here.
Yep, it's really nice. Anytime you get a way to manipulate your hands, get some more card draw as well, always great to have.
Taking a moment to think about which three cards should go back into the prizes. It can be nice to stash things like, you know, energy cards or supporters that you might know you'll need later on, especially if you're planning to like research next turn so you don't have to discard them and then boom, you can get them back when you take a knockout later. And you can also just stash useless cards like Battle VIP Pass into the prizes that you know you're not going to need. And you can always take one of your other prizes whenever you take your prizes because now you know where that card you don't need anymore is placed.
Yeah, it's not face up or anything, gonna be face down, but hopefully you keep track of where you put it and you can go for your other prize cards. So it's information, it's card draw, hand manipulation, all nice things that go pretty well into this deck, especially, like we said, the Mewtwo V Union is a big reason why Peonia is played in this deck, because if there's V Union pieces that are in there, you gotta get them out.
Reversal energy being attached, no locking attacks were used on the last turn, and Prince does have the option of a few different evolutions in hand, the Gardevoir and the Gallade with the rare candy. Which one will he put into play? He's still debating it, and it will be Buddy Catch as the final decision.
Buddy Catch going into the deck here, allowing Prince to get a supporter out. I gotta say, Chip, I'm so happy to see so much Gallade action in this finals match.
Yeah, I mean, a little bit of a surprise. I don't think we saw it at all in Masters throughout the course of the entire weekend. But now we get to see it from both of our players in this finals. Just adding this research to the hand, obviously can't play it this turn as Peonia was used on the last turn. Adding the research now so that it will be something you can use in the future.
All right, we're just gonna cut the deck here. And that's gonna be it. Over onto Drake's side of things. Arceus V, still not a V-star here. Let's see what the top deck was. I think it was another Arceus.
Yeah, not something that you really need.
And actually, speaking of what we need, Chip, are there any Pokemon in the Discord pile?
Yeah, I don't think just yet. And that is also a big problem for Drake. He didn't get to do what he did last game with the Squawkabilly EX, discarding some key pieces. He, of course, does have the Legacy Star V-Star power, but is unable to use it at this moment with Path to the Peak in play, preventing that being an option.
Absolutely.
Boss's Orders in hand for Drake. Does have the option to take a prize here. I also wouldn't necessarily hate just loading some energy up onto this Regidrago, right? Just go for the Trinity Charge this turn, and I think that's exactly what we're seeing here.
Yeah, just developing this board state for the later game, that's a huge strategy. I mean, if you have this Arceus V, you might as well utilize it here. Of course, we still need those Pokemon in the discard pile to be able to use those Regidrago, but you still have the Arceus out that is able to take some knockouts if Prince isn't able to knock it out first.
One thing that does need to be a little worrisome is the fact that Drake only accelerated one single grass energy to this Regidrago.
We have
to remember two are in the prizes.
Two are in the prizes, and that also says a lot to Prince because you're able to search out three energy here, and if that second grass isn't on there, you kind of have that information now being on the opposing side of the field.
Prince did have kind of an unfortunate top deck here, that second Super Rod. He is playing three copies of the card, so has one more available for recovery, but it is just going to be that one option to get back any Pokemon that hit the discard pile.
Looking through the hands here, gonna start with an Ultra Ball. Looks like Level Ball gonna be one of the discards, has to choose one more to go into the deck for another Pokemon. We have yet to see a Gardevoir come out onto the field, so we'll see how Prince chooses to navigate here with all of these Pokemon ready to be evolved. We see that reversal energy already on the field as well. That was manually attached.
Yep, not active just yet. Neither player really having a fast start in this one.
Yep, that Shining Arcana. Gardevoir is gonna be the pick here. Instant evolution into the active position. Has one energy attached to it as of now.
If Prince can hit an energy off of Shining Arcana here, get that accelerated into play, we actually could see a Brainwave dealing just a little bit of damage, 150 set up for a two-hit knockout. Wonder if that's what he's gonna go for. Yeah. No, doesn't hit. He does find the Gardevoir EX and has Artisan in hand, so he can bump the Path to the Peak and go on the aggressive here if he wants to, but his deck is not built to be aggressive. His deck is built to play from behind. You want to be losing the game in the early turns so that you can use that reversal energy to try to come back.
Yeah, finish out strong, take a bunch of knockouts, and win the game from there. Looks like, was that the concealed cards here, Chip? I think it was.
I think it's the refinement.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Yeah, with the path in play.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Path to the Peak in play. Just going to be the refinement for two more cards. Ultra Ball and Switch being added to the hand.
I certainly hope it was the refinement, at least.
No, I'm pretty...
Yeah.
I feel like it was, yeah.
And
I think the energy was just drawn to the front.
Sure.
That's why.
And now we see Buddy Ketch finding a supporter. Prince does play a worker. Was looking at that. Has that in the deck that could discard a stadium card. Also has Iono to be a little disruptive. I don't love disrupting your opponent or giving them a new hand whenever you know they really haven't done much in the previous few turns.
Yeah, the hand has not been too great. I mean, Drake still doesn't even have that Arceus V-Star in play, so you might actually disrupt your opponent. I mean, it's going to be an additional 6 cards if the Iono is used, so that gives Drake a lot more options. So it's just going to be held onto for now.
Ooh.
On Princess. How was that the top deck tip?
Finally finds Arceus V-Star from the top of the deck. Unable to use Starbirth with Path still remaining.
Yes,
but Trinity Nova puts out a lot more damage. Power Edge would not have been able to KO this Gardevoir, but now the Trinity Nova is able to make it happen.
Absolutely, Chip. That's going to be our first knockout that we see here. Prince was charging up, getting that Gardevoir into play over several different turns, and now it is just wiped off of the field here, and that's going to be the first prize card as well for Drake.
And now Reversal Energy is active. When you are behind on prizes, when your opponent has fewer remaining prizes than you, this card provides 3 energy of every single type. So that card is 3 psychic energy right now that could boost for a massive brain wave. Unfortunately, though, for Prince, one of his Shining Arcana Gardevoir did just hit the discard pile. I think I might see another one already in the hand, though.
That would be great to see, because we are down that resource here for Prince. We still have some card draw as well off of these refinement. We'll note that Drake did not draw into the grass energy. Decided to go with the left side of the prize cards, but
yes,
we still have a chance to hit that later on because it's still well within Drake's grasp here. Battle VIP pass, another card being added to the hand. Easy discard here for another refinement on Prince's side of things. Let's see what these additional 2 cards are. Going to be a Mewtwo V Union piece as well as a psychic energy. We're starting to see this hand get pretty big here for Prince. But
yep, and has plenty of options with the Buddy Ketch hanging around. Could be aggressive and maybe go for a boss KO on the Regidrago V-Star. I wonder if that's what Prince wants to do this turn. Gardevoir EX has hit the field. Are we going to see the replacement stadium or potentially the worker to discard it? I think the replacement stadium would be better because then you can boss his orders and take a knockout. And it looks like it's actually going to be the Regidrago V.
With the lack of energy attached to it, it is going to be the V.
It's a little easier to KO. You actually can just manually attach a reversal energy to your active and get there. You're dealing 240 with 2 reversal energy on this Gardevoir.
Yep, less damage counters being placed, less HP on that Regidrago V. Still takes a potential threat, potential future threat off of the field here for Drake, just leaving him with a little less to work with. And here we go. Psychic Embrace is going to pop off here after that bump of the stadium, taking that path to the peak out of play, allowing for this ability. 6 damage counters now onto that Gardevoir in the active position, but all of those energy are being accelerated out of the discard pile to charge it up for a knockout.
Yeah, holding off on using the second reversal energy, I suppose wanting to save it for a little later. I think a boss KO on that Regidrago V-Star with a bunch of energy on it could have been pretty good. This does mean, however, that with the stadium being bumped, Drake has options now. He's got Starbirth. He's got Legacy Star as a V-Star power as well. So if there's key cards in his discard pile that he knows he can reuse, that might even be a better option than Starbirth. Because you get through the deck, you mill active cards that, you know, you already got your board pretty set up. You just want cards in your discard pile at this point.
Yeah, and you know they're still in the deck because we have not seen a lot of Pokemon hit that discard pile. So, I mean, unless they're in hand, I suppose.
And Drake does hit a pretty massive card here, the Judge as the top deck. Prince has built up a pretty large hand, like we mentioned, so Judge could be a really strong option. Limit the hand size, make it so Prince just has less options in the future.
That's what it's going to be. Drake playing that Judge. Both of our players shuffling up into their decks, and they're going to draw 4 cards each. As we said, Drake now has options on the field to continue with this turn, but we're going to see what 4 cards Drake is able to draw into to help out a little bit and navigate throughout the rest of this turn here.
Yeah, and I'm interested to see with what these four cards hold, which V-Star power does Drake go for? Obviously, on paper, Starbirth is the better option. But if you have everything you need in hand, and you know there's two cards in your discard pile you could use, maybe Legacy Star is the move.
All right, let's see what the hand brings. Capturing Aroma, Escape Rope, and two Arceus V-Star are those four cards. We're going to start with the Capturing Aroma here. That is a basic Pokemon on that Tails flip here for Drake.
Yeah, this can grab the Garchomp V that is in the deck. You have an option off Capturing Aroma to discard a pretty powerful Dragon Pokemon, Sonic Strike. Discard three energy attached to your active and deal 220 damage anywhere. Really strong attack to potentially close out a game. And is it the Legacy Star being utilized? I think Artisan going to be used first. This is smart. Get a Ralts out of the deck.
Yep, thin your deck out here so you're not drawing into the cards that you already have access to. Drake playing like a pro here in this match.
Thinking through, I think, whether or not Starbirth is worth it as well. Does he have the Noivern and an Ultra Ball? I mean, those are the two only pieces he really needs. If he has, like, two Ultra Ball in the discard pile, that guarantees it regardless as well. But going for Starbirth seems pretty good. Yeah, just kind of going through the motions here. It looks like Goodra was brought to the front of the deck as well, or the back of the deck, I should say, as a consideration.
I ended up here for sure. Yeah, Drake has options here. We'll just have to decide which route to go, and it looks like a difficult decision as well. Thinking things through, thinking how things go for the future of these turns, depending on what two cards are potentially brought out here from Drake off of a Starbirth.
Yeah, I love the fact that these players are being so methodical. So often we see our juniors players
just play quick,
flying through the deck, but recognizing the moment, taking a chance to just breathe it in, and then also at the same time, keep your pace slow and make sure you aren't making any mistakes.
Yeah, and I mean, both these players brought very intricate decks. These are not easy decisions whatsoever, especially when you're in a matchup that you're not really expecting to go against in the most important match of all, the grand finals here. So this is definitely fantastic here for both our players, thinking through everything. It's going to be the Ultra Ball to discard two Pokemon there.
Yep, just also using Refinement now to get a couple more cards into the hand. Did not discard the Noivern, finding that the Hisuian Goodra would be a better option here since there's no path to the peak to lock into play. Might as well go for the damage reduction and just hope your Regidrago can hang on. And with these players being tied on prizes, Prince cannot use Reversal Energy to its full effect.
Yep, they are tied. Drake would have to be leading for that to happen, but that is another knockout. Both our players tied up now, four prize cards left to take. That's a Regidrago in the active position, but it is utilizing that Hisuian Goodra for that resistance and damage as well.
If Prince can assemble the Mewtwo V Union here, he could go for the final burn. 300 damage and a boss's orders with the Buddy Catch Gallade could take out that Arceus V-Star potentially on the bench. Psy Explosion could maybe spread some damage counter, set up for a two-hit KO on the Regidrago and target the Kirlia on the bench at the same time. A few different options here for Prince. Looks like Research is going to be the supporter off the Buddy Catch, though.
Yeah, we'll have to see what is in the hand here from Prince that will be researched out. Hopefully some more Mewtwo V-Union pieces.
With the Rolling Iron being used, that Regidrago is going to be taking 80 less damage this turn, making it really difficult to get over. So setting up some damage with Psy Explosion could be an option. There is no Giratina V-Star in Drake's discard pile at this point, which is normally the only good way to respond to the Mewtwo V-Union after it receives a bunch of damage from a Psychic Embrace.
All right, there's that Professor's Research. That's another piece of the Mewtwo down. I think there's already one in the discard pile, so still two more to go. Let's see what seven cards Prince is able to draw into from this Professor's Research.
Yeah, not sure exactly what he needs as far as how many more Mewtwo pieces there are to get down. Looks like one, two.
I think it's just two.
Just
yeah.
two in the discard pile at this point. Oh, nope, there is a
third
one hiding at the back.
Oh, so we're 75% there, one away from having that Mewtwo V-Union. Going to see the manual attachment for the turn here for Prince onto that active Ralts. Couple of supporters, but of course, Professor's Research was already used, so upcoming supporters in the later turns.
We are going to see the Memory Skip trying to buy a turn here. Cannot use that Apex Dragon attack now, but Drake does already have Escape Rope in hand, and he also has Boss's Orders. So he could Escape Rope and Boss take out whatever he wants.
Yeah, this is beginning to look a little rough here for Prince, because if Drake is able to really take control of this turn, and it's starting with that Escape Rope, Prince going to have to promote first, that Radiant Greninja coming up. Arceus V-Star going to come into the active position here, but it's just going to be a quick retreat out of it, back into that Regidrago, going to reset the effect that the Memory Skip was blocking here. Regidrago is back online.
Yeah, and Drake is actively choosing not to put another Ralts in play, and players may look at that and think, why would you not put another Ralts in play? And it's actually really smart, because that plays into the Psysplosion, being able to take two prizes at the end of the game. Drake wants to play around that option, make his opponent work as hard as possible, and Boss's Orders, right away, Drake knows what the real threat is. Let's get that Memory Skip Ralts out of here.
Out of here, indeed. That is, like, I mean, it's so tiny, but that is the big threat on the board, blocking Drake from being able to use that attack on the Regidrago. So wiping that off of the field, just another hurdle for Prince to get past. Drake going down now to only three prize cards left to take. That's all that stands in the way of becoming our champion here in our juniors finals. Let's see if Prince can respond here.
Down to just three cards remaining in the deck, I believe. Super Rod is in there.
Three cards left. Yeah, it is the Super Rod, the Manaphy, and that Ralts being taken off of the Artisan.
Yep, Manaphy and Super Rod now being the only options. Buddy Ketch not even able to get a supporter out of the deck. Is there an Ultra Ball? I actually don't think
there's a way to discard.
Prince doesn't have a way to discard this Mewtwo. There's no Ultra Ball remaining. There's not even a Curlia left. Prince's only option would be to refinement it away, and he can't do that until next turn. I think he's going to have to go for the Swirling Slice here and just deal 80 damage to this active, move the energy back to the bench. We are going to see the Super Rod putting a couple cards back, but there are very few options available. One thing Prince does need to be mindful of is making sure there are more than four cards hanging around between the deck and the hand. Otherwise, Drake could just win with a Judge or an Iono. He is getting to that territory, though, where there are not that many cards between the two places of play.
That is scary indeed, Chip. It's all coming down to this here. Only two cards left in the deck. Drake still cutting that deck, though, for sure. Going to take a look through the discard pile here on Drake's end of things. See what's still left, maybe realizing, the Mewtwo V-Union, it's not fully assembled in that discard pile. It's just going to be that attack here from the Gallade, as you said, Chip. Less damage, of course, because of that Hisuian Gudra V-Star, but is able to Swirling Slice, keep that reversal energy on the board, just adding it onto that Gardevoir EX on the bench.
Yeah, of course, reversal energy only gets that extra effect when it's attached to a Pokemon that is an evolution, that is not an EX Pokemon, so or not a rule box Pokemon, I should say. So Gardevoir will still need two more energy cards in order to be able to attack with Miracle Force.
All right, so that is the turn there from Prince, and we're over to Drake here to decide what to do from this turn.
Things are still looking a little sketchy for both players, to be honest. I think Drake is obviously the one who is in the better position. Prince is going to have a hard time dealing with this Regidrago, but if Prince can deal with this Regidrago, I mean, Drake does not have a great way to take three prizes in the next couple of turns. He has to just attack every single turn into a one-prize Pokemon, never able to really get a clean hit into something like the Gardevoir to close out the game. So Prince can try to make sure that this game takes several more turns.
Yeah, and you got to think too, Chip, look at our timer. 8 minutes yep. and 30 seconds
and this
left
is just
on
game
the clock.
Two.
I know, this is just game two. This has been a slugfest of a match, or really two games here between these players.
Artisan now being used by Drake. Sees that Ralts once again, looks like he will not take it. There could become a time where you feel like you're far enough ahead that it is safe to take the Ralts. You can put a Curlia in play, so even if your opponent goes for the Mewtwo V Union Psy Explosion play, takes both of them out, you don't mind it too much. Or it could be safe to put it in play once you get your Gallade established.
Yep, just working through this turn here. Going to see that refinement discarding the Arceus V-Star. Pretty easy choice from the hand. Capturing Aroma, going to be triggered here to get an evolution Pokemon out of the deck.
We still have not seen Drake this game lock in that Noivern EX with the Path to the Peak. That is like the one thing that we have yet to see happen. With the heads flip, did bring Buddy Catch Gallade to the front.
Yeah, just looking through the hand once again, looking through the deck, making these intricate decisions here, but it does look like it's going to be that Gallade there being drawn out.
Still has not played a supporter yet. Does have another energy in hand. Also has the Super Rod in hand. That could be a way to recover maybe a second Regidrago. Is there ever a world where Drake feels like he needs to start establishing a second one?
Yeah, there's a Nest Ball as well in the hand that can just draw it out of there. Capturing Aroma going to get that Gallade out.
I think Drake's saying, I'm going to go back into the deck.
Yeah. I don't need to shuffle up if I'm going right back in. Looks like there's some discussion here.
Yeah, I think just some more thinking. There is a boss's orders in hand as an option, and boss will bring up, I think he pointed out, Radiant Greninja. Let's take that out.
All right, Palpad going to shuffle a couple of supporters back into the deck here.
To
both
boss.
Of those boss that have already been used in the discard pile being put back into the deck. Of course, that Buddy Catch can get them out whenever here for Drake. So those getting shuffled back in is huge. Just grabbing one as well right away.
Buddy Catch it right back into the hand. That way you know you have it. Even if Prince does something to try to mess with your Gallade, it's already in the hand, and if it gets Iono'd, you know they're not going to mess with your Gallade, so you can go get the other one.
You're prepped and ready to go. Boss's orders no matter what. You're going to see the manual attachment there to that Regidrago.
And the pass. Is this a play from Drake thinking that Prince is just out of ways to move this active with only a couple cards left in the deck?
There is a switch in hand, though.
And an energy card. Refinement will also ditch that Mewtwo piece, but I think the only way Prince has to put cards back in the deck is going to be with the Iono, but we are seeing Mewtwo V Union hit the field two games in a row. I think Prince has to go for an Iono plus swing with the Mewtwo play.
That Mewtwo V Union, always nice to see come out here. And Prince doing it again for a second game in a row. Things are seriously down to the wire here for Prince.
All four pieces, all four corners, conquering the Pokemon TCG world. Prince has to be very careful, though. I think there's only a few cards left in his deck and his hand. And now I think he only has five cards left. He only has five cards left, so he can play this Iono. He'll shuffle his hand in, but he has to draw the four cards that he would put back.
Yeah,
he's going to play Iono, shuffle these four cards. He's going to have to redraw them immediately. He will have no cards remaining in deck. And even though this Mewtwo V Union is up and running, it's not going to matter. All Drake has to do is pass.
That is wild to see here, Chip. This is going to be the conclusion of our game with the deck out.
Yeah, Prince is going to go down swinging at least, throw the energies into play, final burn, take the knockout. And even though Drake cannot attack this turn with the way his energy are set up, all he has to do is pass the turn, and Drake becomes the North American International Champion.
Taking it down, missed it at EYC, but hey, is now an international champion here at NAIC. All he had to do was go through one last battle and was able to take a 2-0 victory here in our juniors finals.
Drake, you were giving me the rundown, but tell me when you knew that you had this match in the bag.
It was amazing. Yeah. I was really happy.
At what point in the game were you like, I know I'm gonna win?
Near the last two turns, I knew usually Mewtwo Gardevoirs play 6 Psychic and 4 Reversal, so I just tried to stall them out.
In the very beginning of the match, you were looking for that Arceus and didn't get it. How did you feel there?
A bit sad.
Yeah? How did you come back from that? How did you know that you could still keep playing and win?
I knew I had lots of options in deck, so I just waited to draw into one of them.
You were also playing against Memory Skip Ralts. If other players were watching you play against that, what advice do you have for them?
Keep your switching options till the last and, yeah, just conserve.
Good. I mean, you have been doing great. You won 2nd place in EUIC, and now you're a North America International Champion. You were telling me about your collection. What's that?
Oh, it's a collection of trophies. I've collected the set now.
Having a collection of trophies is a good thing to have. And now you're going to be headed to Worlds in Yokohama, Japan. How are you looking forward to that? Are you excited?
A lot. I'm really, really excited.
What plans do you have for competing there? Do you think you can win?
Hopefully.
We hope so too. Congratulations again, Drake. Again, your TCG Junior Champion. Back to you, casters.